Hi students, welcome to ALFO's e-learning chemistry classes for second year. The running chapter is electrochemistry and now we are in session number 23. In previous session we discussed about measuring standard EMF of the electrode and then measuring standard EMF of the cell and then how to find out which electrode is behaving as oxidation half electrode or which electrode can behave as reduction half electrode from ECS. And in ECS, ECS is electrochemical series, is nothing but the electrodes arrangement in the increasing order of their SRP values or in the decreasing order of their SOP values. And from that, when we are of writing the ECS with respect to SRP value, the increasing order of SRP is nothing but the ECS. In that ECS, the above electrode always behave as OHE and below electrode always behave as RHE. And one more conclusion what we can draw from this ECS is above metals are the best reducing agents and the below metals are the best oxidizing agents. And then coming to that displacement, above metals can displace below metal from their salt solutions. Clear? These are the conclusions and based on this we have to solve some logical questions and some numerical questions from these concepts. And in this session we are going to discuss some logical questions and numericals. Clear? And first one is, The cell reaction of a cell is given. Of a cell is Mg plus Cu plus 2 aqueous giving Cu plus Mg plus 2 aqueous. This is cell reaction. If SRP, standard reduction potential of magnesium is minus 2.37 volts and that of SRP of copper is plus 0.347 volts respectively, then the EMF of standard EMF of cell, E naught cell, is how much? That is the question. And as we know, when both these two are given SRP values, so when both these two SRP values are given, simply E naught cell is nothing but RHE SRP minus OHE SRP. This is the formula what we learned in previous session, is it not? So by using this formula we have to substitute these values. And now which is OHE, which is RHE? Simply you can guess, this is in ECS arrangement, more negative, then less negative, then zero, then positive. Here negative is magnesium, positive is copper. So magnesium is OHE simply and copper is RHE. Now we have to arrange this. E naught cell is equal to 0.347 minus 2.37. That is nothing but 0.347 plus 2.37. That is what you will get, that will be the answer for this question. Clear? So just what we have to observe is with the given SRP values, depending on that we have to decide OHE RHE, then you will get the answer by this formula. And OHE RHE, which is acting as OHE or which is acting as RHE, we can get from ECS concept. Clear? That is about. And the next question, when we move to the next question, here they are providing two reactions, and here they are giving oxidation potentials instead of reduction potentials. First let me write that question. It is the second question, and the equations are given like this. Cu minus 2 electrons is giving Cu plus 2. Here E naught is equal to minus 0.347 volts, and then tin minus 2 electrons giving Sn plus 2. Here E naught is plus 0.143 volts. And now you know from this equation it is deelectronation, nothing but oxidation. Oxidation potentials are given, that is SOP values are given, and to get whether which is acting as oxidation half electrode or which can behave as reduction half electrode, we should know SRP values. And how to get SRP from SOP, already we know, just by taking opposite sign. So SRP values, this is plus 0.347 volts, and for this it is minus 0.143 volts. So once we get the SRP value, simply we can guess which of these two electrode can behave as oxidation half electrode and reduction half electrode. For the purpose, just you observe, this is negative and it is positive. When one is negative, one is positive, above one is negative, below one is positive, thereby in ECS, thereby it is OHE and it is RHE. And now you can get E naught cell either of these two. You can use SOP or you can use SRP. As they are giving SOP values, just E naught cell from SOP is nothing but OHE SOP value minus RHE SOP value. So OHE is this one, 0.143 minus of minus 0.347. That is nothing but 0.143 plus 0.347. What you are getting is the answer. Just you remember, in previous problem they are providing SRP value. That's why we are using E naught cell is RHE SRP minus OHE SRP. But here what they are providing is SOP values. So from this SOP values, already we know three different formulae to get a E naught cell. Clear? So from SOP you have to get the answer like this. That is the second numerical. And now let us move to third one. It is the voltage of cell. Again they are asking where they are providing these half cell reactions, as the voltage of a cell for which the half cell reactions are given as Mg plus 2 electrons. This is the third question where it is giving Mg. E naught is equal to minus 2.37 volts. And the next one is Cu plus 2 electrons. It is giving copper. And here E naught is equal to plus 0.347 volts. And now they are asking E cell. Just from this reaction, it is SRP. Directly they are providing SRP value. It is SRP, and this is also SRP value, and thereby from these two, E naught cell is nothing but RHE SRP minus OHE SRP. So simply you can get RHE of these two. This is RHE and it is OHE. You will get RHE is 0.347 minus 2.37. That is nothing but 0.347 plus 2.37 whatever you are getting is the answer for this question. Clear? And next one is, it is a different one. It is theoretical mode. Now let me give the data what they are providing in this question. Is fourth one, SRP values of magnesium, iron, zinc are given as, for magnesium SRP is -2.37 volts, for iron it is given as -0.44 volts, and for zinc -0.76 volts respectively. All these are SRP values of this, that is when their ions, simply Mg plus 2 plus 2 electrons giving Mg. Similarly, Fe plus 2, 2 electrons giving Fe. Zn plus 2 plus 2 electrons giving zinc. These are the reduction reactions, and here the potentials, SRP values. And now what they are asking is, from this data, which of the following is correct statement? That is, magnesium oxidizes iron, and second one, zinc oxidizes iron, and third one, zinc reduces Mg plus 2, and fourth one is zinc reduces Fe plus 2. These are the four statements what they are giving. From this data you have to conclude. Just let us observe, SRP values are given. It is nothing but ECS based. ECS based. In ECS, more negative should be written first in SRP values. So, and then more negative, less negative, then zero, then less positive. You have to remember forever. And more positive. This is the sequence in terms of SRP, or with respect to SRP measured from with respect to hydrogen electrode. This is the series in ECS. Clear? And now from the given data, all are given negative. But here it is more negative. That's why magnesium is first. It is first. And then of these two, zinc is next. Zinc. And next, third one is iron. This is ECS order as per the SRP values. Is it not? And now when we arrange like this, we know that the above metal can behave as best reducing agent. Above metal can behave as best reducing agent. So the first statement is magnesium oxidizes. So magnesium is not able to behave as oxidizing agent. So first one is wrong. Zinc oxidizes iron. It is above. So when zinc is present above, it is unable to oxidize iron. Next, zinc reduces magnesium. Magnesium is above and zinc is below. So it reduces magnesium is wrong statement. And the last one is zinc reduces iron. That is, zinc reduces the iron ion of the iron. Above, zinc is above iron, thereby it can behave as reducing agent towards this metal ion. So that's why the fourth option is the correct answer. Just you observe again, the above metal can behave as best reducing agent towards the below metal. That is the concept in ECS. So from that concept, we have to observe which is above, which is below. As per the last statement, zinc, we are comparing these two only. Zinc is above iron. So there is a chance for zinc to reduce iron ions. That's why fourth option is the correct answer. Clear? And that is about. And one more problem, that is nothing but again it is also theoretical based on ECS they are providing. it is given like this. SRP, again they are giving SRP values. SRP values of zinc, cadmium and copper, these are given. As zinc is minus 0.76 volts SRP and cadmium is given as minus 0.4 volts and then copper is given as plus 0.34 volts. And again we have to arrange them in ECS. In ECS, as more negative is found with zinc, we can say that it is the first element, above element, zinc, and then negative, cadmium, and then copper, because it is with positive SRP. And now the statements are, which of the following is correct, they are asking. Copper can reduce, this one, this can reduce above two elements, that is first statement is copper can reduce Zn plus 2 and Cd plus 2, that is the first statement. And the second statement is cadmium can reduce Zn plus 2 and Cu plus 2. And third one is zinc can reduce Cu plus 2 and Cd plus 2. And then the last one is zinc can reduce Cu plus 2 but not Cd plus 2. These are the statements given. And again here what we have to observe is, in ECS, above metal can behave as reducing agent towards the below metal ions. Now first come to this, copper can reduce both zinc Zn plus 2 and Cd plus 2. It is below metal. Is it possible to behave like reducing agent? No, that's why first statement is wrong. And then cadmium can reduce Zn plus 2 and Cu plus 2. Cadmium is here and it can be reduce Cu plus 2, no doubt at all, but it is unable to reduce Zn plus 2 because zinc is above that. It can be a best reducing agent towards the metal below it, as per ECS conclusion, and above it, it is unable to reduce. Clear? That's why second statement, because it is given as cadmium can reduce both Zn plus 2 and Cu plus 2, it is wrong. And now coming to third statement, zinc can reduce copper ion and cadmium ion. It is true because zinc is present above, so it can reduce both these two metal ions which are present below it. So that's why third statement is correct. And now fourth one, zinc can reduce Cu plus 2 but not cadmium. When it is able to reduce this one and cadmium is also below zinc, it can also reduce this. So when it is stated that it can't reduce cadmium, it is wrong statement. Clear? Like that, from ECS conclusions or ECS observations, we have to decide the correct option. Clear? That is about this question. And next, let us move to the next question, which is also a logical question. It is given like this. SRP values are given. SRP values of zinc is given, silver is given, nickel is given, and copper is also given. It is SRP of zinc is minus 0.76 volts, silver is given as plus 0.8 volts, and nickel is given as minus 0.25 volts, and copper is given as plus 0.34 volts. These are the SRP values. And now what they are asking is, in which container, very interesting question, in which container CuSO4 solution can be stored? Just you observe, when CuSO4 is stored, it is possible to store this solution in the container which is made of the metal which is unable to reduce Cu+2. If any metal is able to reduce, that is displace Cu+2 from its solution, automatically when we are keeping this CuSO4 solution in that container will dissolve. Is it not? So that's why we have to select the metal which is unable to reduce Cu+2. And as we know, in ECS above 1 can reduce below 1. So below 1 oxidize above 1. So altogether, if we are considering CuSO4, in ECS, all the metals which are present above that copper can reduce Cu+2. So those metals can't be used as the containers for this. But the metal which is below this copper can be used as the container because it is unable to displace Cu+2 from its solution. So for that purpose, first of all, we have to arrange all these electrodes in ECS mode. And more negative is zinc. First, zinc. And then negative is, second one is nickel. And then both these, after this, positive. Now less positive is copper and more positive is for silver. So these two metals can displace this. So they are not eligible. But this metal unable to displace. So we can use silver container. Very interesting question. Just they are asking, and that is also nothing but reducing and oxidizing nature based, but they are asking in a different manner. Clear? And next, coming to one more question here, it is related to deposition at cathode. SRP values are given for different ionic species, like SRP of Cu+2, Ag+, Hg+2, and Mg+2 are given. They are for Cu+2, SRP is given as +0.34 volts, and for silver +0.8 volts, for mercury it is +0.79 volts, and for magnesium it is -2.37 volts. These are the SRP values. Clear? And now what they are asking is, the sequence when the voltage is increasing, that means all these ions are present in the same electrolyte here, that Cu+2 and Ag+ and Hg+2 and Mg+2, all these ions present. And now we are passing current. This is cathode. At cathode, these metal tend to deposit. These ions tend to deposit. That is, they are going for reduction. And now when slowly we are increasing the voltage, the order of deposition of these metal ions, they are asking. For that purpose, already we know, at cathode, the metal with a higher SRP deposits first. Is it not? We know, at cathode, this is the conclusion drawn from ECS again. So of these, the higher SRP value is observed with silver. So silver first, and then after silver it is mercury, after that it is copper, and the last metal is magnesium. This is the order of deposition at cathode. Like that, So we are having different logical questions here. All these theoretical questions we have to answer purely depending on the ECS concept. So that's why it is a very important. You need not by heart the values. They are providing the values. As you observe, in all these numericals, they are providing the SRP values or SOP values. Just you have to consider these SRP values in terms of ECS. Then you can easily guess the answer from that ECS concept. Clear? Okay, in the next coming session, up to this session, what we discussed is, in case if SRP or SOP, that is standard potentials, are known, we are doing the calculations. And that standard electrode potentials can be known by constructing voltaic cell with a reference electrode like hydrogen. All this we did. And now in coming session, in case if the electrode is having electrolyte at other than unit concentration, then how to measure the electrode potential, single electrode potential, and then how to measure EMF of the cell which is at other than standard condition. All it will be covered in the coming sessions. Clear?